Hey everyone, Roger here, and I just wanted to share my goals for 2023. I know I'm gonna be behind. Talent and Chip have already done their goals, but I want to do my goals for Movement Radio Productions, but also my goals just personal life. I'm hoping that sharing my goals will help some of you share your goals, be more open with it. Maybe we can keep each other accountable and we can reach our goals together. That's the goal for 2023, is, you know, make sure we reach our goals. So real quick, I just wanted to start with my personal goals. I have 5 goals. Let's get right into it. So goal number 1 this year is that I want to read at least 2 books a month. And in 2022, I read about 13 books, I think, maybe 14. But some were short novels, but a majority of them more self-help and improvement books. And this year, I really want to read majority of improvement books that will help me reach my goals and also to better myself mentally and physically. Books on the list that I have so far include The 5 A.M. Club, Make Your Bed, Mamba Mentality, 7 Habits of a Highly Effective Person, Can't Hurt Me, The Power of the Subconscious Mind, books like that. I think I already have one. I'm looking at my bookshelf. I'm being lazy and didn't have it right there. But I do have a couple on the list. 5 A.M. Club I see over there. But I do have 5 A.M. Club over there for right now. I need to get Make Your Bed and Mamba Mentality soon. 7 Habits of a Highly Effective Person I think is on order. But yes. But speaking of mentality, let's move on to goal number 2. And I want to learn to meditate. This will help with my mental health. And in 2022, I actually helped my mental health a lot. I focused on my mental health a lot. I needed it. I left social media in 2022, I think in February, maybe end of January, beginning of February. So I've gone almost a full year without social media. It really did help my mental health a massive amount. I didn't have to worry about anybody else's life, focused on myself, was able to do my things. Majority of people that I talked to, I already have their number or they have a way to reach me anyways. So really not to worry about that. And another goal that's going to help me with my mental health is, just meditating. Because it'll help center me. I know it's weird. It's weird talking about this. I know. But it'll help center me and also help me take more control of just things that I can control and not worry about the noise outside, help me center, improve the mental health. And I think meditating at least 10 minutes a day to start out is really going to help out in the mornings, probably before I go work out or after workout, just to keep myself balanced, keep the positivity. Enter the day with a positive mind state. The day will be positive no matter what it throws at you. I do believe that. And I've been trying to show that put that forth more often. I plan to do that at least 10 minutes a day to start out, just to help out the mental health. And I think it's also a way to sort of drown out that voice in your head that's maybe negative and bring the positive one forth, because you're just tuning everything negative out. So just one of the things I want to work on is meditating more, or learning to meditate, and then meditate throughout the day at least once a day, 10 minutes a day to start out. So goal number 3, most people do this when the new year starts, working on your physical. I did set out a goal in 2022 to improve my physical self. And of course, I want to keep doing that in 2023, because you can always work on yourself physically as well as mentally. I meal prepped more. I did eat better. And I did end up losing 10 pounds and keeping that weight off for 2022. In 2023, I am sitting at 220 pounds now. I do want to get down to at least 200 pounds for this year. And I do have a few ways of doing that, and I will be doing it. But I do not recommend this for people starting out or people who haven't really worked out or prepped or anything like that for the year. But I will be cutting out all added sugars in food, so breads, cookies, anything that has added sugar, aspartame, stuff like that in general. I'm cutting that out, which is really, really bad because everybody knows that sugar is very addictive. But I will sort of balance that by still eating fruits. And that will be my only sugar source. So it's really, really going to be tough. And not only that, I'm also going to be cutting out caffeine at the same time. It's crazy. So I'm taking out sugars and caffeine all at the same time to begin the year. But I think it'll help me with that meditation, mental health, my nervous system. Caffeine does help your metabolism, but also has some kind of sometimes a waning effect on people's mental health and nervous system, so it gives difficulty sleeping. So I'm trying to improve my sleep as well, especially since we're waking up earlier than I'm already used to. But I used to drink 2 to 3 cups of coffee a day and 2 to 3 cups of tea a day, so my caffeine intake was a lot. Just this first week, I've cut it down, reduced it to 1, which has been really hard. I've been sort of feeling I can feel the cravings or anything like that, especially with sugar too. But no, those are my 2 more things. Definitely going to test out my willpower. So trying to do this thing where I put it out there and keep accountability so other people know, be able to check on me, you know, keep my accountability. You know, if I fail, I fail, but I want to keep trying. You know, one slip up's not going to, I'm not going to make one slip up ruin the whole year. Obviously, if I do that one slip up, I got to work harder to continue doing that. Also, I'm intermittent fasting. I'm going to be doing just the standard 16-8 plan. So I will only be able to eat between the hours 11 a.m. and 7 p.m., which is mostly my work day anyway. So I'll be waking up at about 5, between 4:30 and 5, hitting the gym, getting a shower, obviously, getting ready for work. I'll make my breakfast before I go to work, let it cool down, and at work I won't eat until 11 o'clock. So about 5 hours of being awake and physically active before I eat. Not only that, no caffeine to start out the day. So water intake. Yes. But I'm going to sort of also do this goal by doing physical activities that I enjoy or workouts that I enjoy doing too. I'm going to try and rock climb more this year, hiking more this year. 2 things I really enjoy, jump roping. Running on fields, I know it's weird, people are like, oh, running is the same everywhere, but no, running on a field is different than running on just sidewalks or the treadmill and stuff like that. Also going to the gym and doing workouts that not only do I enjoy, but push me also. Probably going to try and work on my arms, chest, and back more this year and see if that will help me with lifting a little bit more heavier weight to also boost my metabolism and also cut some of this fat off. So, you know, just crazy goal, I know, but I think it's going to help me with the little that I did in, I say a little, but with what I did in 2022, help me with 23 and 3's goals. All right, so goal number 4, personal-wise, is growing my spiritual path. I'm not going to go too in-depth with it here, because at Moving Radio, we obviously don't talk politics, we don't talk religion, we don't push any religious agenda or anything like that at all, but I just plan on praying more and closer to God and my belief system, have him guide me for the path that he has set for me and for Movement Radio, obviously. Take it as you will. I'm not trying to do this to upset anybody, but just my beliefs. Like I said, putting stuff out there like this will help other people, obviously, put stuff out there like this to feel like a sense of belonging to. So I know some people are also, you know, spiritually unsatisfied, trying to find their way or anything like that. Same way, I do have a belief system, but I do feel like I need to get better at it and just grow on a spiritual path, like I said. Goal number 5, better time management. I'm super shitty at time management. But I'm not the only one out there. A lot of people can relate to this, I know. And out of all my personal goals, this will be the hardest. I do dedicate a lot of time to Movement Radio, spend countless hours making content, doing research for content, and just ways to grow the brand or anything like that. When I do work, I work an 11-hour shift, 10 hours working, 1 hour lunch, So there goes majority of the day there. So yeah. So trying to go to the gym, go to the gym, work, make content or research content or anything like that. Spend time with my baby, just growing as a person or anything like that. We all have the same 24 hours. Other people are able to do it. I should be able to do it. And I know it's going to be really hard to do this, but you know, I can't make excuses anymore. We're not here for excuses. We're here for results. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get results. I'm going to get myself a planner. Yeah, I know I have a phone like everybody else does and I can put stuff in there, but I think writing it down will mentally make me more, susceptible to do it, I guess. And just plan stuff out. Obviously on my off days, stuff a little bit easier, be able to make more content, ahead of time, push it out that way. And then just get to the gym. Like I want to at least an hour a day, 45 to an hour. If I can, but yeah, those are my five personal goals. Now let's move on to my goals for Movement Radio. Pretty much in line with the same as the guys and everything like that. But But in 2022, Movement Radio definitely had a lot of growth. We had to change things around here and there. But we definitely had a lot of growth, tons of opportunity, which we are grateful for. The last half of the year, we really had an explosion, which, I mean, for us as creators, really, really made it seem worth it. I think as a whole, we set out to make YouTube our focus for 2022 and hope to achieve the 100 by the end of the year, which we did by far. So thank you guys. We're sitting about 145, I think, at this point. So that's really great to start out the year. We're just, you know, trying to do more growth and stuff like that. We're grateful for everything. Love you guys. So goal number one, obviously, is grow the YouTube channel more. With content that you guys really, truly want to see, but also content we enjoy making. Now I've set a goal to get to at least 500 subs by the end of the year. We're at 145. So it seems plausible and doable. But obviously without you guys, we can't do this. And we really appreciate it. If I don't make the 500, I'm not going to beat myself up for it. The closer we get to it, the better, obviously. But 500 is a goal. We appreciate it. It's not saying that anything under 500 is not worth it, because people watching our content, enjoying it, and subscribing to us really does mean a lot. I mean, we're making content that you guys want to see, and we get feedback back and forth, and we do really put that into perspective when we make stuff. But yeah, we also have shifted around a lot of ideas and put some content out we assume you guys wanted to see. But when it came down to it, some of it you guys actually didn't want to see is what we want to see. We were projecting that way. But, you know, I'm going to make stuff. I'm speaking for myself here. I'm going to make stuff that I like to watch or my interest, you know, anime, comics, movies, video games. I want to make content based on that stuff. And obviously there's people out there that like that stuff too. So why wouldn't I make stuff I like to make and I can actually talk about and have that personal connection with, instead of trying to find something and latching onto it and hoping that we catch fire like other people? I'm not here to fake it. The guys aren't here to fake it. We're really going to do stuff that we want to do. And hopefully, you know, us putting our heart into it will, you know, show you guys that we're serious about this and help grow our channel. Goal number two, this is going to be really lengthy again. Sorry, guys. Goal number two is to collab with bigger names in the YouTube community. And now, you know, it'd be awesome to, you know, be saying, hey, we're going to do a video with Mr. Beast. That'd be fucking awesome. But not yet, hopefully. Maybe soon. Maybe down the line, that'll be a thing. Go with Mr. Beast. Maybe a goal for 2027, maybe. I don't know. But now, I personally want to work with people that fit our community and are also pillars in the YouTube community that pertain to what we make. I want to reach out and work with, you know, guys like, you know, obviously you want big names, like I just said, Mr. Beast, Jacksepticeye, stuff like, you know, RDC World. That'd be awesome to work with those guys. They're great, and they're the funniest fucking people on YouTube. Not even gonna lie about that. I love watching those guys. But no, I'm reaching out to do collabs with people like in the comic community, anime community, movies, TVs, and just wrestling community, stuff like that. I'm gonna run down a list of people I want to make work with and everything like that. Comics Explained, probably my favorite comic channel, on YouTube. Chiseled Adonis, I think one of the funniest people around. His commentary, he does sports, social events, everything like that. It's hilarious. Go check him out. I also want to work with Jordan French, make some great TV nostalgia and video games content. Matt McMuscle has been watching him for 10 plus years now. Did You Know Gaming? Obviously, I love video games. I want to learn about video games. I want to dive in depth. I love, especially their 2022 was amazing. They did a lot of great work. Too Hype, obviously, you know, big names in sports and just group activities in general. Like I said, Jacksepticeye, Willie Madden from Willie Versus, TK Breezy, you know, just esports organizations out there, you know, just work stuff with their guys. I know Chip would love to do Optic Gaming. I would love to do 100 Thieves, you know, just stuff like that. Just ways to collab. But on our end, all we can do is really reach out to these guys and hopefully they see it. Maybe somebody out there watching this knows ways for us to get in contact with some of these people and be able to work, do videos with them. You know, all we can do, like I said, is communicate, put the work out there. Hopefully they catch it or somebody passes it on to them. They like what we're doing. They want to work with us, or we, you know, we do reach out and they do answer us and be like, yeah, that'd be cool to make a video or something like that, or do some content or something. Which sort of sucks from my end because I'm not on social media, so it's going to be even harder for me to be able to do this. So I'm putting this sort of on the guys, which really sucks. I know it's me being selfish, but like I said, being off social media really helped my mental health, and I don't feel like breaking that because I don't think it's worth my mental health to go and do all that again. But, you know, if you guys out there are able to find a way to get in contact with them or make a connection for us, networking is great, everything like that, we would really, really appreciate it. I know I would. Let's go ahead and move on to the next goal. I'm trying to make this quick. I know it's going to be a long video. I'm sorry, guys. Goal number three for Movement Radio, for my goals for Movement Radio, is to make a more consistent upload schedule or just content schedule in general. It's pretty self-explanatory. No more random uploads. No more, you know, just video here, video here, video here. Hopefully, you know, you guys see it. No, be more consistent with our videos. But it should be easier because we communicate a lot and we should be able to go back and forth about when we're going to upload or anything like that. But we're going to try and make a more consistent schedule Monday through Friday and upload stuff, actual long-form videos, shorts, live stream, of course. I'm going to try and get back into that. But no, it's not going to be just random. Most likely we'll set a community post, or it'll be on one of the socials that the guys will post up in that way. But Monday through Friday for sure. Weekends will probably be just shorts or streams, just something like that, because that'll be a little bit more casual and calm. But I'm expecting to hopefully be able to do two videos a week myself. Chip and Talon are trying to do two or so videos a week themselves. Hopefully, once we get a more consistent schedule, you guys will be able to figure out what we're doing and follow the videos that you guys like. Obviously, you know, you're not going to watch everything from all three of us. That's kind of crazy because we all don't have the same interests. We know that. So once we get a schedule down, you'll be able to follow which one of us you like the most, or just see what we're all doing that way and just be able to catch up with us and stuff like that. Goal number four is I plan to do at least one major project, video project. I'm going to try and save at least one major one for the year. If I could get two for the year, that'd be amazing. It'll be something a lot different than what we normally do. I would really like to do stuff like food reviews, like restaurant reviews, food reviews, mukbang, stuff like that. I don't know for sure yet, but something like that. you know, we go get food from a restaurant we all like, or just a new restaurant we're going to try out, or something like that, recommendations, whatever. We go get the food. We go sit at a table, you know, we eat the food, you know, be like, yeah, this is good, you know, boom, 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 stuff like that. Or, you know, critique it. If it's bad food, we're going to say, you know, it's bad food, whatever. You know, like the one chip challenge stuff, spicy food challenges, and stuff like that in general. You know, this videos like that. Also go to like escape rooms, you know, see us and a few of the guys, me and some of the guys, some friends and everything, go to escape room, try to figure puzzles out, get pissed at each other, fuck up or whatever, and, you know, just do stuff from there. Haunted attractions, you know, haunted mazes, haunted houses, stuff, just stuff like that. Maybe even do like a paranormal investigation. That would be really, really great. Just stuff like that. I want to do at least one major video like that. Obviously con videos, but con videos will be more of a quarterly or hopefully eventually a monthly kind of video anyways. But I want to do one massive major video project. Maybe a massive game of hide and seek. Maybe, you know, one day we're just out there on social media. It's like, hey, we're going to go to such and such place, go do a big hide and seek game with a bunch of fans and friends or whatever, who wants to be a part. You know, something like that would be really great because I'm still a kid at heart and like playing hide and seek because who doesn't? But, you know, something like that, that is something showing more of our personalities also that way. Because, yeah, the videos will show our personality and everything, like gameplay, stuff like that, just reviews, whatever. But being us out there person-wise with other people, boom, interacting and everything, will show more stuff. And goal number five, before I say goal number five, I'm just trying to tell you guys, it's not a greed thing or anything like that. It's more of a, what's the word? Not us being selfish and greedy, but just a validation kind of thing. And I know that's weird. It's still not the right word. I don't know what the word I'm trying to say, but it's for a good reason. Goal number five is make our first dollar off of YouTube. And like I said, it sounds selfish and greedy, but no. Making our first dollar for YouTube as a group just gives us a sign that we're heading towards the right way. And all this work was worth something for somebody out there in general. You guys are enjoying it. We're getting, like I said, we're getting tons of feedback. It's great. We love doing this for you guys. And I just wanted to know, be known that, you know, hey, yeah, we're doing this. Here's like I said, a dollar hits our account, bloop, a dollar. And I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it's worth it because people out there are enjoying it so much that somebody put an ad on our video and a link was clicked and they supported us in a way, indirectly or maybe even directly in our merch store. You know, go to our merch store. We have, you know, great shirt merch. You know, My Hero Academia shirt. We have a Dragon Ball Z shirt, which is really great too. I don't have that one on. We have our Movement Radio logo. We have the Duff City one. We have jackets, everything like that. Stuff like that is great. Always in our description, we have our store merch link first. So you can always go click that. But no, it's just, you know, really a way to do that. You know, just stuff, you know, sort of just saying, yeah, yeah, you guys are doing this. You guys are doing great. People love you and people do want to see you. And, you know, advertisers are taking advantage of that, but it's all right. Because we all work, Chip, Tal, and I all work normal, regular jobs. Like I said, I work 11-hour shifts. I think Talon works 10 hours, 9 or 10 hours. Chip also works 8-plus hours. And we have families, you know. So we have to go do that too. But we also balance the content life and the family life. And, you know, it's just, it make it seem more worth it. But, you know, it's just love for you guys. And thank you for everything. I know this went long. I'm sorry, guys. I'm super sorry. But hopefully, like I said, just, you know, help somebody out there. We can keep accountability, keep goals. Reach out to me. You can always reach us on our email, Facebook messengers, social medias, anything like that. And if anything needs to be said directly to me, the guys usually tell me, pass along, or anything like that. I do check the emails too. So just reach out to guys. Oh, the comments. Leave comments. I talk to the people in the comments. It's an easy way for me to do that. But, you know, if you guys enjoyed this, as always, leave the like. I'm not good at this. Just subscribe, leave a comment, share with your friends and family. You know, leave a like. Be honest with us. Leave us a comment on videos. Be honest with us. Let us know what you liked, what you didn't like, how we can improve, stuff like that. You know, if you guys really do enjoy us, obviously subscribe and share with your friends. We're just three dudes trying to make this enjoyable and entertaining and trying to make people happier. You know, 2022 was a good year. 2023 is going to be a better year. So together we can make this a great year. And hopefully, you know, we're able to do something for you guys that, you know, you guys will love and keep coming back for more. All right, guys. Thank you for listening. I'm sorry for talking your ears off, cutting off my hair, flip, fade, or whatever transition I'm going to do. Boom.